everybody, and welcome to another episode of Jurassic World Alive. So before we get into the video, this will be the only Jurassic World video I'm going to put up today, because I recorded a Jurassic World the game video earlier, like last week, so this hasn't been a week past. But Jurassic World Alive, oh my god, I got so much to talk about, because we have possibly one of the best events ever. And yes, my facial hair has grown a lot. Isn't it beautiful? Not really. It's mostly a neck beard at this point, I know. But how about, before we get into what's happening with me, let's have a look at what's coming up next week over there. I think, is it there? I think it is. Anyway, so this is the Jurassic World Alive second anniversary. For the second year, this game has been out. God, wow, really already? It's been 2 years? 2 years since I was in America. 2 years since I interviewed Jeff Goldblum. Wow. That's crazy. Okay, anyway, so this, you can see, we've got a lot of flipping things to dart. These are crazy good. So Monday to Tuesday, nothing to write home about. You got Archotherium and Instrakovnia, which are the two, well, one of them's definitely the new Cenozoic, or, you know, that kind of, before dinosaurs, that area. And really the only thing to write home about is that we get a new incubator, which is good. And on the Tuesday, there is a rare and a legendary incubator to get. Rares. From Wednesday to Thursday, we have Badgerosaurus, Titanoboa Gen 2, Klenikin, and Miolania. Out of those, I would probably suggest, I'll be going for Klenikin and Titanoboa. Barragosaurus I see quite often, and Melania I see quite often. And then on the Wednesday, we have the health mods or boosts to get. And on the Thursday, we have a rare incubator. And now we're entering the beginnings of the weekend, and this is really where it starts to get interesting. So on Friday, one chance to dart either Quetz Orion or Ardentis Maxima. Now, if you want the most DNA, I would probably suggest that you go for Quetz Orion. Because Quetz Orion's not going to... It's, you know, we've seen the animation set when it moves. It's quite easy to dart. And I can't see it going too crazy. Now, Ardentis Maxima, on the other hand... Yeah, you've darted a Brachiosaur, what's it called? The Brontosaurio, that one. I can't remember what it's called. Those darting types are really hard, because you can go from the tail all the way to the tip of the head. So, you know, and that's going to be really hard. But if it is Ardentis Maxima that you want, probably suggest darting that. And as well, we get this. What is it? Hold on. Where are you? Scutosaurus. That's it. It's a thing that gets killed with walking with beasts. That's it. So this guy, or is it walking with monsters? Walking with monsters. This guy has been revealed to have a hybrid at level 15. So we had some more Russian leaks. So if you haven't already started to dart this thing, which you probably have, if you've seen it, you've darted it. Because I would imagine that if you've seen it, you're like, oh my god, it's a new thing, get it! You have to get it, everything has a hybrid eventually. Apparently it's going to get a hybrid in the near future. So, stay tuned for that. And on the Friday, we get the legendary incubator for it. So a guaranteed 500, is it, I think? Now, on to Saturday. We get another scent, we get a rare incubator as well. And we get one chance to dart Indoraptor, Gen 2, a Phosphosaura, or a Smilocephalosaura. Now, out of those things, you know, I'm just gonna... Phosphosaura, you, what do I need to make you? Myosaura and Phosphoracus, or whatever it's called. Meh. And the Smilocephalus, I think I need... The turtle? Oh, the Apache. Okay, so, out of all of these, out of those Indoraptor Gen 2, Phosphora, or Smilocephalus, whatever it's called, I'm probably going to dart Indo Gen 2. Not because somebody told me to dart it, but because blue is a really hard creature to come by. I don't think you can spot it in the wild. So, out of everything, you can get all the others in the wild. So, why not dart an Indo Gen 2? And I know... I don't want to do it, but we've got the, if we go onto the battles and we go onto leaderboard in 7 days, I'm guaranteed, well, at least I think I'm guaranteed, 3,000 blue DNA. That's going to go towards my Interrupted Gen 2, and then I'm going to be darting that Interrupted Gen 2. So, yeah, I'm going to do it. And then on the Sunday, we have a legendary and a rare incubator to get, as well as 6 chances, 2 dot, very generous, Indominus Rex Gen 2, Titanoboa, Thicklacator, or whatever it's called, or Carbonemus. That's a tough one. I'm tempted to go for Carbonemus and Titanoboa, one of those, but I mean the Thylacotator, whatever it's called, Thylacotator. I'm not too fussed about Indominus Gen 2. I think I've got plenty of that DNA. Yeah, I got 3,000 of that, because all you need is, I think it's Tyrannosaurus Rex Gen 2 and Delta. I've got, Delta is what spawns in my area all the time. So I do not need Delta. I have 53,000 Delta. I don't need that. And 28,000 of this. So I could, if I really wanted to, max out Indominus Rex Gen 2. But there's no point in doing that until we max up or even get anywhere close maxing up Indominus Rex. Oh, sorry, Indoraptor Gen 2. And that about wraps it up for Jurassic World Alive second anniversary. And judging by the creatures that we're going to get out of the incubators, you know, the rares you're going to get is probably a Clenican or a Titanoboa Gen 2, and the epics are going to be Carbonemus, Titanoboa. The incubators themselves are going to be really good, and the scents that we're going to get, because we've got 1, 2, 3 cents, and you can only have 2, so you're definitely going to set one of those off. As for me, playing this game has probably been the most frustrating week I've had in a long time. I don't know why that is. If you see, I'm in the Lockwood Library. I'm used to getting 5,500 to 5,700, you know, cups or trophies. It's just not been, I don't know what's happened. I really don't know what's happened. And you might be thinking, well, Beavers, you're not putting your boosts on. Nani? I have actually put my boosts on, because as you can see, there you go. I can't boost any creatures. I put some boosts on the Trico. I put some boosts on Erlodominus, I think. Yeah, I boosted all of its attacks. So now it has like 2,100 attack. But still, just something about the opponents I'm facing. I don't know. I usually go up quite high near the end of the week when, you know, everybody's sort of sparsed out in the leaderboards, but I don't know what it is. Maybe more people are playing? I have no idea. Anyway, let's see if we can get at least something. Not a 10, a 30, I'll take it. That's good. So we've got 100 left, and then we get a level 30 Erlodominus. Also, look, you see this? I can twizzle it, so I look a bit French. But let's have a look. Gemini Titan, I have a chance to, hopefully not a 10, please don't be a 10. Oh, 20, I'll take it. I was prepared for a 10. I was prepared, but a 20's good. 20's good. It's just a shame because you level up so quick, and then you get to a point, it's like, oh my god, it's such a slog. and we have one pop for the Dimetrodon. This is it. I mean, Dimetrodon's the... Oh, 40, yes! Oh, getting close there. 100 more for Erlodominus to level 30, and 130 more for Magnetator. Now, these creatures I think I will always end up using. Always. And we may as well open up these incubators to see if we get anything extra. We might get a little bit more Dimetrodon DNA. And that way, we can just give that extra pop, because I'm only like 20 off. Let's see, maybe in this one. Very rare, but maybe? Oh, come on! Damn it! Not quite. So, tournament ends in 2 hours. This is the team that I've been running so far, and what I've found to be working all right. I'm out of everything, the weakest one I would say is probably the Carnotaurus, like the Carnotaurus hybrid. The best one, you have to have the Sarco, whatever it is, the Sarcotrix, whatever it's called. And if you do get that, put it out first, because if they, you know, you get a good matchup, they can't switch out. Do I get it? No, I don't. And actually, for the first time in a long time, I've got Sinoceratops. Okay. Right, out of all these, best thing to start with... I don't know. It's all up in the air. I haven't been having good luck with this. I honestly haven't. As you can see, I'm not really that high in level. Now, this isn't actually too bad of a matchup, because even if he goes for Mutual Fury, we can kill him. So, you know what? I'm tempted to go for... actually, you know what? I'm not going to do it. I was going to go for Evasive Stance. He's got an attack that goes through it, James. You're an idiot. And you would have wasted your go. Hey! That would be great, eh? Oh, dear. Okay, so, I mean, I may as well just go for Distracting, right? Like the big hit. I might. If he goes for Cloak, well, at least I'm probably going to kill him in the next hit. He does go for Cloak, but I'm all right. I think I can still kill him. Oh, I can't, because I think it's 1,500. Yeah, I can't kill him. So I'll do this, but this is good, because that means that the next creature that can come in can at least set up a little bit. And he'll just go for his big... Oh! What happened there? Oh, that was lucky. That was super lucky on my part. Ooh, the new snake. I've not really faced this too much. Okay. Raking counter. It's immune to distraction, is it? On escape, dust cloud. Okay, I'm going to go for this. May as well. I'm probably going to get one hit in anyway, either way. So, but if I do evasive stance, I have a slight chance to, now what do I go for? Each do the same. And he doesn't take a distracting. Yeah, if I do the evasive, I might do two hits. Otherwise, I'll take it. Now, let's see. Oh, well, there you go. I definitely do take two hits. I'm sorry, don't do two hits. I take two hits and die. Precise impact. Ooh, he should have known that. You know what I could have done? I could have went for the distracting and then survived and then gone for the bigger hit. That is big brain play. That's what that was. Now. I'm going to go for this. Now, he gets rid of Cloak, right? That's what his... when receiving... remove dodge and Cloak. But it does not remove a shield. So what we're going to do here... he has no armor. What's Sinoceratops' 950? Do we leave him? Yeah, we do. Okay, so I'm going to kill him with... Or so I'm going to do initial hit with this guy. But we could stay in, though. If he does a shield, however, yeah, that's the annoying thing, because now I can't, oh yeah, we can kill him. Do I switch out? Oh, do I stay in? I kill him. Yeah, I may as well. I'm not going to show that I have that just yet. Okay. Ooh. Interesting. He's not quicker. He will go for instant distraction, though. I think. He definitely will go for that. So... I might go for dig in. If he goes for instant distraction... Nah, you know, sod it. I'll play it. Oh, oops! Oh, I'm an idiot! He didn't go for instant distraction either. Whoops-a-daisies. Two times attack... okay, you know what? That's fine. At least I do hits to him. I very rarely face this thing. It's not the first time I've done this either. I forgot that I can't swap out. Does he have a bypass shield? No, he doesn't. Okay. Instant distraction? That's fine. Go for it, dude. Go for it, my dude. I'm just going to go for Bello now and just make sure that you, get hit by me. Yeah, precise rampage. So I've still got my shield up. There you go. And I get to hit him back for 550. Oh, it's not looking good for him. No, I'm quicker now. He does have... he does, however, have it, though, doesn't he? I could switch out. He could go for... He might be going for instant distraction. But you know what? I'm just going to make sure that he's slower. I could have tried to switch out there, and I was tempted. But you know what? I'll go for the instant distraction. Just to get him slower. Really, I should have tried to switch out there. And then gone for another dig in. That's what I should have done. I had a feeling he was going to do that. Okay. So. What do we do here? I think. Yes, we're going to take a hit. But at the same time, he doesn't know got sign. And he has... His snake is on really low health. He's slower. He's vulnerable now as well. And then I just switch in, right? Okay, precise rampage. Oh, he gets a crit as well. What's the chances of that? 5%. Okay, and now we're just going to swap so we can definitely kill him. Oh, wait, I forgot. I'm an idiot! James, why did you keep doing this? Oh, wait, he went for instant destruction anyway. I'm such an idiot. Oh, my God. Beavers, after you said that this thing's a really bad creature to bring. Oh. Oh, wow. Okay, yeah, I guess having Sinoceratops is not good because Trichosaurus and Sarco, whatever, both don't allow you to swap. Now, what's he going to do? Yeah, he should have went for long protection. Yeah, that's the smart play there. And now I can go for this and kill him. Yeah. Because it doesn't matter what he does. Actually, he could go for instant distraction. Yeah. Well played. Well played. Well played. Nothing I could do. I've lost this one. 3-1. Oh, that's annoying. That's annoying. If I had something other, anything other than, whatchamacallit, Sinoceratops, I might have stood a chance there. I might have stood a chance. Oh, that's annoying. That is an overwhelming defeat. Oh my God, that was horrendous. We're getting rid of Sine. It's useless. No point. No point having you in there. Right, we're going to go for Gorgosuchus this time. Gorgosuchus will see me through. That was a horrendous battle. Oh my God. Right, defeat three creatures. Come on, give me Illogamma. Not bad. Starting with the Sarco, because it is the best thing to start with, I found, anyway. I say that, and I'm not even doing that well, so don't listen to me. okay. What should we go for here? Should we just, like, slow him down? Yeah, we'll just make sure that he can't, like, rampage and run. At least within the next two turns. Oh, well, at least I stunned him. That's good. Wow, Beaver! Small brain plays here. Very small brain plays. At least I stunned him, I suppose. Thank God. I'll take that. Right, okay. I guess I could have stunned him. Yeah, that's the best play I could have done, is stun and then gone for the hit. Because now he's got a, yeah, precise pounce. Precise pounce. Do I do no damage now? I think I don't do any damage. Oh, no, I do. Oh, at least I got to stun him, though. And he can't switch out, so we kill him. Yeah, you can't swap. Why? Hey, he's doing big brain plays like me. Oh, wait, he's immune. Oops. It's even bigger brain plays. Okay. So what are you going to do? Another immune creature. Yeah, okay. You could definitely kill me. Definitely kill me. Yep, fair enough. I'll take that. What your Illogamma is the win condition that he's got. I don't think Illogamma is quicker than Pro Serato, so I've got to bear that in mind. What do I do here? Oh, there's nothing really I can do. It's not looking good because I can't nullify him at all. I mean, he's going to go for 1.5 and kill me. It's like perfect. Oh, no. Oh, okay. Fair enough. I would assume that he's going to go for Illogamma back in now. Oh, never mind. This actually might have worked out. Yes. Did I have this? I don't think I had this one. Yeah, delay. Okay, that's fine. Ooh, it's a tricky one. I've got to go for this. I've got to go for this. Right. I think I've played this the best I could have. I don't know if there's any other way I could play this. Just better team in, I guess. Regeneration? Oh, yeah, okay. I'm still going to do a hit to you, and now I can do a big hit. Fine, I guess. Now what? Why? Why do it? Okay, I think I'm quicker than Illogamma, so that's that taken out. It depends what other creatures he's got. His own Gorgosuchus, who's immune. Right, well, I guess I do this. He's got immunity, right? Oh, no. Oh, cleanses himself. Very good. Very well played. Okay, now what's he got? Okay, right. He just wants... He's probably foddering off my distraction attack. Oh, for his own Procerata Mimus. Ooh, okay. He's going to go for a nullifying here. And then we've lost.
Yeah, there's nothing I could do.
Nothing I can do, because now he's going to go for like 2x damage. So there's the best I think that's the best I could have done. With the team that I had, I've just got to take that defeat. There you go. That wasn't like I did stupid plays. That's basically his loadout was better than my loadout. And, oh, I don't know, just recently, like this last week, it doesn't matter whether it's these tournament battles, it doesn't matter whether it's just the regular battles, I've just been losing. Time and time again, I don't know whether it's because, well, with the normal battles, it's like just because people can buy boosts now, like everybody has a Thordor with like 149, 133 speed and like 2,500 attack. So they wipe the floor. And I saw somebody put like an image of ages ago. It's like a Gaming Beaver Jurassic World Alive video. It's like, oh yeah, I get to play this. And I'm just screaming at them like, dude, they've all got mods. They're all better than me. They pay. Oh dear. But I mean, because that's an option, it's just an easy thing to go to. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no. He's gonna be quicker. Yep, he's quicker. Okay. Fair enough. Well played. I've gotta take that. I mean, I could switch it out for something else, but I'm okay. I'm okay losing Sarko. Yeah, maybe I could have lost the Carno. I don't know. Maybe we'll see. It depends what team he's got. It really does depend what team he's got. But we can definitely kill this guy. He might go for a cloak just to be cheeky. I don't think I can do anything to that. He might. No. Yeah, he is going to go for the cloak. I'm pretty sure I've killed him even. Oh, and I got a crit as well. Oh, and it went through. Oh, all of the luck. That's the luck used. I've lost the game because I'm not going to get lucky with anything else. That is 20% luck, though. Plus the 66% chance to evade as well. Okay. So what's he going to do here? I mean, I'm going to save Gorg. Oh, I could go for a big hit and just try and do a big hit. Because he's going to do instant distraction, right? That's what he's going to do. So he didn't. Are you serious? That was... I mean, okay. Am I immune? I might be immune. No, I'm not. Okay, fair enough. Turtle can come in then. Whatever. Gorgosuchus is pretty quick. But I can definitely survive another hit from Proceratomimus. So, as long as Proceratomimus can't do its nullifying, and I've got my cleanse, I can kill it. Yeah, there it comes. That was the kill shot. Alright, now what's he gonna do? What could he do? Nullifying? I guess. It's not looking good for him, though. He's gonna lose it. And best he could do now is, like, evade or switch out. He might just go for another nullifying, though, just to do damage to it. Yeah. Yeah, probably the best. If he's got better creatures, which he probably does, that's the best thing he can do. Let's just hope that it's something slow, so I can do my dig in, go faster than it, devastation. But that's too lucky. Ooh, right. Like, what can you do here? You're probably going to go for your shield, right? So you're going to half, and you're not that quick. I mean, I'll go for dig in. Either way, he's probably going to do shielding, and he's going to go first as well because he gets to slow me down. Oh, well, let's see. Maybe this worked. Right, because he gets that for one turn, right? And he's going to go first. Now, he has no priority moves. What's that? Right, raking 1,000. He has to do less than 1,000 here with his first hit. Please do less than 1,000. Wait, did he still kill me? Did he still kill me? Did he get a crit? Oh, it's 1,500. Oh, what? What? Oh, he did the ferocious. Well played. That was very well done. Very well done. So he doesn't get to bypass shield. So I may as well put mine up or else I'm dead. I have to do that. Ooh, it's teetering and tottering on a knife's edge, this battle. Oh, is it going to be three losses in a row? Can Beavers make it three losses in a row? Let's see. Oh, I've survived. Oh, he's cleansing himself, so he's going to do a fair amount of damage here. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. Oh, now it's all down to whatever somebody's going to do. He's only got his Pro Ceratomimus. I'm going to go for cleansing, and we've done it! Hey, we won! Oh my god. Jesus! And look at that, I win one. 20 cups. Because apparently he was lower than me. Oh god. The one thing I want to win, the one time I want to win the rewards for this. And there it is. I get 10, 10, and 5. I'm pretty sure I got 30 or 40 last time. Yeah, I think I was in top 500 players, so I got 40. Oh, man. But anyway, guys, I don't know. I haven't been enjoying playing Jurassic World Live. I'm not going to lie, because every battle is like a loss. Like I said, tournament or just the regular, just Lockwood and, you know, battles, I've just been losing. And like one night I was just playing it for an hour and I didn't win. And I was just thinking to myself, I don't have time. I don't have time to spend an hour to, like, because all I want to do is get the incubators. That's it. I don't care about winning, right? But to win, to get the incubators, you have to win. So I have to keep on playing until I get the incubators. I want to say, like, maybe it would be better if, even if you lost, you got the incubator. Maybe if you win, you get a better one? I don't know. But it's just like, oh, I mean, it's just one of those, like every game, everybody has games that they play, but they go through bits where you're like, oh, I'm not enjoying it, man. I'm not enjoying it. But then like, as long, it picks up. As long as it picks up and it gets better, fair enough. But right now, I'm not liking it. I hate this game at the moment. But anyway, guys, enjoy this video. Remember, link in the description down below. You can get 50 bucks, so hopefully that'll go towards more boosts, eh? Eh? If you enjoyed it, leave a like. Until next time, I'll see you later. Oh, bye-bye.